Hi everyone, welcome back. Welcome to the third video, and this is going to be our final video in the segment, how to transition yourself from an individual contributor to a manager. Now, in the last two videos, I talked about what are the fundamental differences between an individual contributor and a manager. And when you become a manager for the first time, what are the things that you must try to avoid? In this particular video, we're going to talk about what are the things that you must do and must concentrate on when you become a manager for the first time. And if you have been a manager for 1 year, 2 years, or if you are a first-time manager, I think you should try to look into the content of this particular video. It might help you a lot. So without much wastage of time, let's move to the screen and start learning. Hi everyone. In this video, we're going to talk about and learn about what are the must-dos of a first-time manager, which is going to be very, very interesting. So let's get started. When you become a manager, one of the first things that you should target doing is to separate personal from professional relationships. Have some one-on-one discussions going on with your close colleagues or friends who used to be your peers, and set up some expectation going forward. Now, this kind of situation is challenging for most of the first-time managers. Yeah, it can present a very uncomfortable situation because the same people with whom you used to work side by side doing the same daily task are now your reportees. So you are not responsible for doing those tasks. Rather, you're responsible for their performance. Yeah, and it can present a bit of uncomfortable situation and can create some workplace tension. So instead of waiting for some months or year to see how the relationship develops, I think this is the first thing that you should consider targeting, so that you can bring in your friends and your colleagues and your peers who with whom you had developed a deep bond and some trust. They should be on your side first, yeah. And if you fail to take them on in confidence, then it might mean that your job would be more challenging. But in case you are able to set up the expectation upfront with them and reassure them that although the organization has given you a new role, this does not affect in any way the relationship that you have with them or they have with you, right? They should be absolutely clear that this particular role that you right now have does not threaten the relationship between you and them. That's the first thing that you should do, and try to set up some expectation over there. And that can do wonders for you and your management career. Imagine the trust, the bond that you have with them. They can be your right hand and left hand, right? So if you can get them on board with you, I'm sure that not only you would be working hard to be successful as a manager, they can actually provide some helping hand to you, in your career as well. So why wouldn't you want to do that, right? So do not wait for that kind of discussion to happen, right? Just sit with them, have a word with one-on-one, make them understand that it's the organization which has given you a new role, and outside the office environment you're still friends, you're still peers. However, there might be a situation that within the office environment, since the organization now demands a particular work done by you, so you are now responsible to manage the performance of the entire team. So it can happen that you might have some rough conversation with them, or you might have some difficult routine with them sometimes. But that does not mean that your relationship is in danger, right? So you still respect them, and you want them to support you in your thing. And also let them know that without their support, you will not be able to be a successful manager, right? So have those discussions going on pretty early on. manage your own expectation as well. Not everyone would be on your side in the team, since you were one of them before. Every move of yours would be watched, and you must prove yourself all over again. It's a new job, so whenever you're starting a new job, you have to let go of your past laurels, and you have to focus on what this particular job demands of you. So you have to start fresh, you have to start from the scratch, and you have to earn the respect of your team members, right? So you need to manage your own expectation as well. Not everybody in your team might be on your side, right? There might be green eyes. There might be people who might be thinking that, okay, we performed well as well, but how come you got the promotion and not us, right? So there can be those kind of people. And you cannot control 100% all these external situations, right? But what you have control on is on you and yourself, your behavior, your conduct, what you are going to do. So I think you must focus on that part. There might be people who will be bitching about you at your back. But if you are true to your job, if you are doing justice to your role, if you are being a good manager, trying to do everything for the team, taking care of the team, I'm sure that over a long period of time, those people will also start coming on your side. Spend time with people first, get to know them, their ideas, their challenges. This will help you to get some more respect from your team, and you will get to know your people as well. Do realize that you have now transitioned from an individual contributor to a manager. So it's not about your performance we're talking here. It's about your team's performance. It's about them rather than you, right? So they come first and you come last, right? So that's the difficult job of a manager. So you have to know them first before you expect them to know you. And you'll find a lot of managers and a lot of leaders do this quite opposite. They start talking about them, how they got growth, and they're so full of themselves, and people can see through, right? So be curious about the people that you're managing. Try to know them better. Ask them a lot of questions. Spend time with them. Ask them about their ideas. Be humble enough to ask more and more, and be a bit conservative when it comes to what you have done and your achievements and all. Be a bit low on that part, right? Because it's about them now and less about you. Keep working in your previous role for a while side by side. This is a great advantage when you have just got promoted from an individual contributor role to a management role. This basically gives you a competitive advantage against your competition or much more senior managers. Because do remember that when somebody is managing people for over 5 years or 10 years, they go very far away from the ground level realities or the skill sets that required as an individual contributor. Those technical skill set, it might be some other skill sets, they go far away from those because their job responsibilities change, and so what happens is a lot of delegation happens. People hardly see managers. When the situation arises, when some critical issues arise, people hardly see their managers getting their hands into the dirt and rolling up their sleeves and getting into the work. It's not that managers don't want to, but a lot of time managers are challenged because they have lost that skill set, right? So due to that, a lot of delegation happens. A lot of statements come out like "get it done" or "I want you to get it done." Don't ask me, ask your seniors. A lot of statements like this floats around, and that does not help the respect factor, right? So but when you become a manager, right, you are still in touch. You have just become a manager, so you still possess those skills that helped you to become a manager. So use that, right? That gives you that advantage over other managers. Yeah. So do not let that individual contributor skills go away, and try to make sure that you work with the people side by side as you used to do before. Do not just change your place and seat. Sit isolated, right? Don't do that. That will trigger a kind of wrong perception in the team, right? So when your people will see that not only you are taking additional responsibility as a manager, but you are still contributing individually to the team's success, it gets you that respect and acceptability that you want from them. I'm not saying that you continue doing that, but do that for a few months, right? To get their respect and acceptability. And since you are just out of that role, doing that would be much more easier initially rather than later. Ask them about the idea of changes required in the team, and don't tell it. Asking is a form of giving respect, and telling is termed as a bit disrespectful. It's more authoritative stance that you take. So always ask team about their ideas. People should feel respected under you. Always remember that the job role of a manager, yeah, that's the most important thing over here to remember. Your technical expertise or sales expertise or any other expertise that got you here is never the focal point now. Enabling your team members to develop and then showcase their expertise goes to the heart of your mission. Although you should retain some element of the individual contributors' skill sets, since it promotes the leadership element sometimes and helps you to have a clear understanding of issues at the ground level, so you do not act as routers only. You know what routers do? Routers just keep routing internet packets, right? So so something comes here, it routes to the other device. So don't act as routers, or don't just work as a manager who delegates everything to some people or the other. Sometimes it's better that you share one responsibility with the team. So it sounds a lot better when you say that team, these are our responsibilities, and I would look into this particular thing personally, so let's get it done. It's a lot better to have that kind of conversation rather than having a conversation saying that since I'm the manager, I'm telling you this plan, this is basically the sharing of responsibility, so just get it done and we'll meet next week. Unfortunately, that kind of conversation does not work, especially these days with millennials in our workforce, right? So please share some responsibility and show some skill sets as an individual contributor also. Focus on cultivating trust. Creating trust, developing trust is very difficult, and it takes a very long, long time. You cannot measure trust, so you cannot measure monthly or weekly or yearly. At this point in time, nobody has developed any tool to measure trust, right? Maybe in future we'll have something, but at this point in time, trust is still an intangible metric, and you still do not know when and how trust gets created. But we do know that what are the things that contributes to trust, right? Those small talks, when you walk the talk, when you talk the right things, and when you take responsibility for the team, when you look after the team, when somebody is in trouble, somebody is going through personal issues, you practice some empathy with that person, right? Little things that contributes to trust building. So focus on cultivating trust. Continually asserting your technical expertise fights the trust building process. So do not always, even if you are, technically well capable, even if your skill sets are unmatchable, right, compared to your team, do not always keep asserting your technical expertise, how great you are, what all things you can do. Don't assert, even if you know that if I if I let the team do this particular task, the quality of the task might not be, as high as you are expecting, right? Because a lot of time we suffer from bias of our own experience. So we want everybody to do tasks like how we used to do, right? And that's not a good practice. So let the team, share their ideas, let the team take on some responsibilities. And even if they do some mistake, correct them, give them feedback, but do not, continuously assert your expertise in that. Instead, you ask questions, encourage individuals to offer and pursue their ideas. Resist your instinct of answering everything. Yeah, it's a great thing, and it's very difficult to practice. So even if you know the answer, you do not answer. Yeah, that's the difficult thing, and that's something that will come to you with practice. A lot of practice it needs. It sounds easy, but trust me, when you become a manager and somebody comes to you with a question and you know the answer, how difficult it is to not to say the answer. It's like Socrates. It's like guiding your person to the answer but not telling. It's like teaching somebody how to fish and not giving that person directly the fish because you know how to fish, right? So don't answer everything. Rather, if somebody comes to you with a question, ask him some follow-up questions so that he himself gets directed to that answer. And if at all he cannot answer after some time, then you can provide the answer. But do that practice of making those people find and discover the answer themselves through questioning. A manager does not have to be the expert of everything. You can take the final call post the discussion, but do allow discussions to happen and idea sharing to happen. It promotes trust, respect, and engagement. Manage up and filter down. Again, a very important aspect of the first-time managers, because when you become manager, you have some reportees and you also have your boss, right? So you are in the middle, right? When you are an individual contributor, you are on the boundary. You didn't have anybody reporting to you, right? So you are not in the middle, you are on the edge. But now you are sandwiched. you're right now sandwiched between your reportees and your manager, right? So you need to manage both ways. You should not only manage your reportees, you should also have to manage your manager and your senior management. So as a first-time manager, you'll be exposed to parts of the business strategy and operations that you were not aware of as an individual contributor. So a lot of updates, a lot of senior management team interaction will happen with you, which never happened before. And you will come to know, some information at a strategy level, of the organization. And that is where this particular skill set is very important. And it can be very difficult as well. It can be very tempting to get some important updates and then pass it straight onto the team, thinking that, I got this information which I never used to get before. So let me just pass it on to the team and impress them. Trust me, that will backfire, right? So you need to act as a filter. Not every information that comes from the top should go through you to your team. And similarly, not every information that comes from the team to you, every feedback should go to the top management without filtering, right? So you should act as a filter always. You should be prepared to manage up by sharing information on your team's morale, performance, and concerns with top management. So if somebody comes to you and complains about, I did not receive my cab for pickup to the office today, that's also a feedback, right? So it's up to you whether you personally take that with the transport department or you would like to share that feedback with the top management, right? It's up to you, but of course it's a one day issue, right, with one person. So you have to act as a filter and think, okay, this information need not be escalated further. I can take care of it. But if somebody comes up and says that I'm facing some harassment from a person, then you might have to engage your top management or a sexual harassment committee, right, in your organization, right? So you have to act as a filter. Similarly, if you are getting information regarding the company's revenue are not doing well this particular quarter, it's up to you whether you want to disclose that information to the team, right? And it completely depends on your corporate policy about what are the information that should be available to the team and what are the information which should not be. Nowadays, it's a bit relaxed because we have an open door policy. You know, transparency is the order of the day. So nowadays, this particular challenge is a bit less, but still, you will have to filter information, you know, down to your team, making sure that your team's morale is always high and your team are not getting demotivated through reports which can become good later on. Last but not the least, always ask for help whenever needed. It is not a sign of weakness as a lot of managers think. It is a sign of growth and strength. When you ask for help, you're not getting help. That's not only that part you are getting done, but also you are kind of providing a lot of respect to your team members, and your team members might be feeling very proud and respectful and getting valued that their manager is actually asking their opinions and their help, right? So their self-esteem would be very high if you do that. So it not only works in order to get you the help required, however, it also helps the team members for you know, in terms of engagement and esteem, right? And with that, you are actually practicing good management and good leadership stuff. So, you know, it will definitely help you going forward as well. So it's a kind of a growth mindset that we talk about. The main issue that we are trying to address in this particular segment is, since you have become a manager right now, your performance, your individual performance does not matter now. It's your team's overall performance that's basically matter. And you're going to be evaluated by your manager, by your organization, by the standards of your team's performance and team's behavior. So it's not about you anymore, it's about them. So you need to approach this particular work and role with that mindset. It's very, very critical. And that's where a lot of managers struggle initially. And that's why I made this dedicated segment of 3 videos where I try to address what are the things that you should do, what are the things you should try to avoid when you're transitioning yourself from an individual contributor to a manager. And I hope it helps you. Now, the next segment that we are going to plunge into, people management. It's going to be very, very interesting and fun, because here is one segment and one aspect of management which is really struggling in 21st century. We are so much machine-centric right now in our thinking and in our metrics calculation and all, that we are no longer human-centric. Even if you talk about departments like HR, human-centrism just disappearing in this particular century. And one of my mission and motto is to bring that focus back onto people management. And we are going to learn quite a lot and discover a lot of aspects of people management. It's going to be fun and interesting. So stay tuned, keep watching Let Us Lead. I'll see you in the next segment, in the next video, when we start with people management. Till that time, you take good care of yourself and keep watching Let Us Lead. Bye-bye.